Once again, welcome students. I am your bio teacher Vikas sir from Eklavya Educational Complex. Dear students, I hope that you all are staying cool at home and enjoying the online classes. Isn't it? Very good. Keep doing the hard work. In previous classes, we studied up to a cytoplasm. We just started the what are the criteria to identify the true cell. So inside that we study that there are three components inside the cell. Through which we can determine a cell is true or not. And that three basic components are first one cell membrane, second one cytoplasm, and third one nucleus. We studied up to cytoplasm. Today we will start our new topic, that is nucleus, the third basic component, that is nucleus. So nucleus is known as brain of the cell. Why it is known as brain of the cell means it control all the activity of the cell. Just like our brain control all the activity of our body, likewise nucleus also control all the activity of the cell. That's why it is known as brain of the cell. Second point is that what is the location of nucleus inside the cell. So there are different location or different loci at where a nucleus are located. So there are different positions in different cell where nucleus are located. In animal cell nucleus are located at the center. But in plant cell, nucleus are located at the corner side. Reason behind that, why it is located at the corner side, because in center of the cell, in plant cell, inside the plant cell, in center large vacuoles are located. And that's why nucleus are at the corner position inside plant cell. Now next point is what? Nucleus contain hereditary material. In the form of DNA, which transmit character. That means DNA is responsible for a transmission of character from one generation to next generation, from parents to their offspring, likewise from one generation to next generation. The full form of DNA is deoxyribonucleic acid. full form of DNA is deoxyribonucleic acid. And for that means character is transmitted from one generation to next generation. So there are lots of character. And for particular character, particular gene is responsible for transmission of particular character. Particular gene is responsible. So here one new term comes, that gene. So what is gene means? As we go through the definition of gene, then we can write the fractional segment of DNA. The fractional segment of DNA. The fractional segment of DNA is called gene, which is responsible for carry a character. The fractional segment of DNA is called gene, which is responsible for carry a character. Carry a particular character. Hai na? Suppose that parents hair is curly, then that is transmitted from their offspring. That character is transmitted from their offspring. So hair gene is responsible for transmission of hair character into the offspring from parents. So likewise, for every character, for every particular character, particular gene is responsible. Now next point is we can make it more clear what is gene. So this is DNA. Suppose the length of this DNA is 10 meters. So what is the fractional segment of this DNA? 10 by 1. That means this DNA can be divided, we can divide this DNA into 10 equal parts. We can divide this DNA into 10 equal parts, and each fractional parts and each equal fractional parts is said to be gene. Each equal fractional part is said to be what? Gene. And each fractional segment is responsible for carry a particular character. It's responsible for carry a particular character. Now moving toward the towards the next point. Next point is, what is the structure of nucleus? What is the structure of nucleus? So nucleus is also double membranous structure. Nucleus is also double membranous structure. Nucleus is also double membranous structure. This one outer membrane, and this is inner membrane. This is outer membrane and this is inner membrane. And the liquid portion, or the semi-solid portion, or the not semi-solid, the fluid contents inside the nucleus is known as what? Nucleoplasm. Is known as nucleoplasm. Inside nucleoplasm, a dark spherical body is located, and that is known as what? Nucleolus. That is known as what? Nucleolus, which is responsible. Nucleolus is responsible for the formation of ribosome, a cell organelle which is present in both eukaryotic and prokaryotic cell. Which is ribosome is present in both eukaryotic as well as prokaryotic cell. And nucleolus helps in the formation of ribosome. So nucleolus is known as, protein factory of the cell. So nucleus is known as protein factory of the cell. Inside nucleoplasm, a thread-like structure is also present, which is known as chromosome. Which is known as what? Chromosome, which carry hereditary material in the form of DNA. And one thing just missing that between in between the nuclear membrane there is a small pore present in between the nuclear membrane, that is known as what? Nuclear pore, through which substance can also cross inside as well as outside the nucleus. Substance will in and out from this nuclear pore. Now moving to the next point, that is, what is difference between DNA, chromatin and chromosome? So first we have to go through DNA. Newly synthesized genetic material is known as what? DNA. Now second one is chromatin. So what is chromatin means? When this DNA link with histone protein, coiling of DNA get started, and the early phase of coiling of DNA is known as chromatin. Early phase of coiling of DNA is known as chromatin. Now third one is chromosome. When this DNA get fully coiled form of DNA is known as chromosome, which is more stable than newly synthesized genetic material. So today this much only I am going to give you some questions in the form of assignment. You student go thoroughly to that question, read it, study it well, and try to solve and try to attempt all the question. If any doubt is there, you can ask in the Google. You can ask that question in Google Hangout Meet. From Google Hangout Meet at 2 PM or the coming classes. Thank you, students. Have a nice day. Enjoy the online classes. Bye.